Western Australia, a big state sparsely populated by tall, rangy sand gropers who nip over to Bali like it's a trip to the loo. Who've long complained about $4.50 coffees, insane rental prices, and FIFO workers wearing high-vis at the casino. But now they've got something new to moan about, other than people from the East Coast calling them up too early in the morning.
Hello?
Yes, with the mining boom well and truly over, their once unstoppable economy has been overtaken by New South Wales. Yes, the state that all Australia loves to hate has one more thing to hate it for, and it's not their up themselves, sun-tanned, cockroaching Mardi Gras ways. It's because they're making the money, more money than everybody else. Out today, Commsec's State of the States report reveals that after 3 years at the top, the economic performance of WA has been overtaken by New South Wales. One of the unlikely reasons was Sydney's urban sprawl, spurring on a housing construction boom that's coincided with the decline in WA's mining revenue. But what about the rest of Australia? Victoria, the Garden State, full of Mexicans, home of the world's most livable city that fails to take into account miserable weather, a frankly pathological obsession for AFL, and the propensity to wear black and eat dimmies like they contain real human food. And yet, according to Commsec's report, Victoria is fourth on the ladder with solid population growth, yet a high unemployment rate. They even fall behind top enders who, in between negotiating the wildlife and being branded by red-hot seatbelt buckles in the sun, have managed to actually do something productive in the heat and come in at number three. The land of cane toads, Bob Catter and drunk teenagers at schoolies coming in at number five. Next was the crow eaters slash serial killers in South Australia, who came in at number six. Australia's home of roundabouts and blue ties, the ACT, is at number seven.
You're not saying anything, Tony.
And there's more to feel sorry about for our apple-eating cousins in the south. Tasmania, who may or may not be able to even get SBS TV transmission, is at the bottom of the economic performance table. But what the report shows is the changing tides in Australia's economy, our fundamental shift away from natural resources and onto a more uncertain future. But regardless, you say potato cake, I say potato scallop, you say swimmers, I say dick togs. We are all Australian, except for Western Australia, who has wanted to secede from the rest of us since 1933.